Hi everybody, myself Lieutenant P. Suresh Naidu, ANO Government Polytechnic, Ballari. I am taking online classes because, as you all know that, due to COVID-19 pandemic, I hope you are all fine. Stay safe and stay at home. Today we'll learn about chapter 1, that are aims, objectives and organization of NCC. Today we'll come to know about introduction, aim of NCC, objectives of NCC, organization of NCC, NCC staff, training activities of NCC, organization and structure of NCC, and lastly we'll have the conclusion. First, let me give the introduction. With an aim of raising the second line of defense and to create a large pool of trained youth available for armed forces, during the First World War, university corps were started by British government. This is done to groom the young people, boys and girls, to direct their energy towards national building by making them responsible citizens. It is called second line of defense because you know that the first line of defense are the armed services. And after much evolution, after the Second World War, after independence, the present day NCC formally came into existence on 15th July 1948 through 31 Act of Parliament. The Girl Division of NCC was raised in July 1949. On 1st April 1950, Air Wing was raised with one Air Wing squadron each at Bombay and Calcutta. The Navy Wing of NCC was raised in July 1952, thus representing all three services of the corps. Third, today the NCC has an enrollment strength of more than 30 lakhs cadets and consists of two divisions in all three services. Yes, you know that NCC has 13 lakh cadets, which is the one of the biggest organization in the world with uniform, and the two divisions are junior division and senior division. Junior division is for high school boys and girls, and senior division is for college going boys and girls. And again it is subdivided into SW and SD and JW and JD. Now we'll come to the aims of NCC. Any organization to be successful, to run smoothly, it should have an aim. As such, NCC has aims in three folds, which is achieved by practically theory and hand-on experience. First, to develop the following qualities in cadets. Character, the mental and moral quality of an individual. Comradeship, how he behaves with the fellow members in the organization, which is very important. Discipline means to obey the rules or code. Secular outlook means not connected to any religion. Spirit of adventure, bold and risk-taking nature will be developed. Next, idea of selfless service, defined as a service which is performed without any expectations or results or awards. See, these characters or qualities of a cadet are improved. First, the character. The character is improved by arranging camps, taking responsibilities when given, obeying the orders of seniors, etc. These all characters, when improved, he becomes naturally a leader. The second fold states the same. To create a human resource of organized, trained, motivated youth to provide leaders in all walks of life who will serve the nation regardless of which career they choose. Here the best example is our Prime Minister Narendra Modi, who was also an NCC cadet. There are many eminent persons who have enrolled their names in NCC and been an ex-cadet, and they have carried the legacy of NCC. To come to the last fold, that is to provide an environment conducive to motivate youth Indians to join the armed forces as career. As the cadets come in contact with the officers, PI staff, they come to know about the regimental way of life. By seeing the officers and PI staff, they get motivated to join in the Indian Army. Now we'll come to the objectives of NCC. First objective is train the volunteer youth to become confident, committed leaders in all walks of life. Enhance awareness level of cadet to become responsible citizens of the country. Provide opportunity and encourage cadets to enrich their knowledge, develop communication skill and build character. Conduct social activities and community development programs to make constructive contributions towards the society. Undertake adventure activity and to hone leadership qualities, risk-taking abilities. Provide a platform to launch Goodwill Ambassador to project the image of the country overseas. This is done by Youth Exchange Program. Conduct military training to develop awareness about armed forces, leadership skills, military values. Provide an environment to motivate the cadets to join the armed forces. Organization of NCC. The NCC is a voluntary organization which is administrated through the Ministry of Defense. The NCC headquarters is situated in Delhi, headed by an officer of rank Lieutenant General, who is responsible for smooth functioning of NCC in the country. Now it is headed by Lieutenant General Rajiv Chopra, AVSM. There are 17 directorates located in the state capital, headed by an officer rank of Major General, Brigadier or equivalent from 3 services. Our directorate is Karnataka Goa Directorate and is commanded by Air Commander L.K. Jain. Direct trades have up to 14 groups. Each group is headed by an officer of rank brigadier colonel or equivalent known as group commander. You know that we belong to Ballari group and is commanded by Colonel Birendra Kumar. Each NCC group headquarters control 5 to 7 NCC units or battalions commanded by Colonel or Lieutenant Colonel or equivalent. Our unit is commanded by Colonel Rajendra Malik. Each battalion consists of companies which are commanded by Associate NCC Officer ANO at the rank of Lieutenant, Captain or Major. You know that I am an ANO of Government Polytechnic Ballari. In all, there are 99 group headquarters in the country who exercise control over a network of 700 army wings, units including technical and girls unit, 73 naval wings units and 64 air squadrons. There are two training academies, namely Officer Training Academy Committee for Men and Officer Training Academy Gwalior for Ladies. Now let us come to the training activity of NCC. Training activity of NCC can be broadly divided as under institutional training, the training which is carried out in the institution, camp training, the training which is carried in the camp which runs for 10 to 12 days, attachment training, formal training organized by attachment with Army, Navy, Air Force unit, Navy Air Wing activities, seamanship, navigation, communications and other associated naval subjects are taught. Air wing activity, aero modeling, airmanship, navigation, aero engineering and micro light flighting are taught to the cadets. Remount and veterinary activity. This activity is primarily meant for horsemanship and riding. This is an organization and structure of NCC. Here you can see a first headquarters Director General NCC, Director General NCC, Lieutenant headed by Lieutenant General, and addition we have two additional directorates. Apart from that we have 17 state directorates and 99 group headquarters and 837 units in this 700 and army or army, and remaining how it is distributed, which is self-explanatory. Air Force are 64 and Naval are 73. Now let me come to the conclusion. NCC as an organization has unified the youth not only of our country but has made significant efforts to interact with the youth of other countries through youth exchange program, thus expanding the scope of its training and ultimate goal of attaining unity. Now let me come to the summarize the things. First is aims of NCC. As you all know, the aims of NCC are threefold: to develop qualities of character, commandership, discipline, secular outlook, spirit of adventure, and ideals of selfless service in the cadets. The second fold, to create a human resource of organized, trained, motivated youth to provide leadership in all walks of life who will serve the nation regardless of which career they choose. To provide an environment conducive to motivate the young Indians to choose the armed forces as careers. Organization. NCC headquarters is situated in New Delhi and there are 17 directorates located in the state capital. Directorates have up to 14 group headquarters and each NCC group headquarters controls 5 to 7 NCC unit or battalions. There are two training academies, namely Officer Training Academy, Kamti for Men Officers, Training Academy, Gwalior for Ladies. Now let me come to the staff, NCC staff. The staff, NCC staff, by regular officers, permanent instructor, PI staff, associate NCC officer, girl cadet instructor, whole time lady officer, and civil staff. Training activities of NCC are institutional training, camp training, attachment training, remount and veterinary activity, air wing activity, naval wing activity. Thank you. If you have any doubts, you can ask through message, WhatsApp, etc., which will be cleared in the next session. Thank you.